Hello and welcome back. We are just about to take a nap after having a talk with Yennefer, and we couldn't give the little boy who has the doggy. I got him that doggy, but that doesn't really matter. The chalk. I would like to just put it on his bed, maybe. You know, that's good enough for me. You know, he's gonna find it in the morning and he's gonna be like, yay! I don't need to be like there, hey, I'm the one who gave this to you. Like, no, that's fine. But we have to rest first, and hopefully they're gonna be fine, because it seems like maybe like a cliffhanger for something. Are they gonna be fine? A few hours later. Are they just gonna go away, get captured, and
wake up
in the death camp?
We need to move.
Who the hell are you?
What's going on?
Everyone, wake up! You need to get out of here.
Who the fuck are you?
It doesn't matter. What matters is that you can't stay here any longer.
She asks a question, and I suggest answering.
You don't want to do that. I've got this place rigged with explosives, and there's a detonator in my pocket.
That makes it hard to
you
trust
got
you.
What?
Would you mind? Lower your gun, Ryan. He's the one that saved my life. What do you want from us? You have to get out of here. Skynet's on its way. They finally found you.
What do you mean they found us? They were looking for us?
Not for you. For him. He's essential to winning this war. Skynet knows that. That's why they've been following him for months. I have to make sure nothing happens to him. In a couple of minutes, an infiltrator will walk in here trying to kill him. I can't let that happen. We have to bury that Terminator here once and for all.
One Terminator?
All right, everybody, you heard him. Let's get moving. I'll get the bus ready.
There's no time for that. There's a passage here. It will lead you out. Use it.
What was that?
All right, everyone, get out!
Seems like it's the cue to
Jacob!
Leave.
Jacob!
Give me that. It's the same one. It's the same model. Leave! Now!
Oh, nice.
How the hell's he still alive?
Go! 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 Watch out!
Seriously? Oh. Yes, plot armor
too. Don't just stand there! Run!
Can I shoot? Really? That's just one Terminator. I've killed a Terminator before. Oh, we're going to the resistance shelter? I guess fuck that guy who saved my life. Why not just like... Why not warn us earlier? He definitely had time to rig up the place with explosives. Why not warn people, then rig up the place maybe? Or maybe organize some kind of defense? You know, there are a lot better ways to do it. Like, hey, what up? We just have to go, but also this place is rigged with explosives. You know, or did he do that much before? Like, when did he have fucking time? Why did he rig the place with explosives? I don't know. That seems a bit of a stretch. You know, just in case it's gonna be needed.
Baron listened to us. She could no longer deny that this infiltrator was a real threat. She decided to take everyone in, on her terms.
Oh no.
The shelter was on high alert, but thanks to the intel I gathered in Pasadena, we slowed the advance of the Annihilation Line and gained some time. Just enough to start preparing the counterattack.
What? 2 weeks later, back to Pasadena. So I guess they are just heading out in the resistance hideout now. I leveled up twice. Okay, where the hell I am? I'm going back to the resistance hideout, by looks of it. And next level, we will have access to level 18. So, I have a choice of either rushing or what we can do is go explosives, next level go weapons, and just like put all the points into toughness after that. Or, of course, crafting is kind of useful too. But I think explosives are just so damn good. I mean, it does seem a little silly that I'm not putting points into survival, but I'm dying so fast. So we would need to put in a lot of points here just to make a dent. And 40%, I might do it, you know, but that could do it. And that might be more important, but I kind of like the idea of like going with explosives here. Although it doesn't work against Terminators, but it works against the big ones. But it's not like mandatory at all. I don't know. So weapons for it basically useless. It's not as useful as many other. But it's weapons. You use them. Use weapons all the fucking time. So, but it's not a big bonus. That's my point. I kind of like toughness. So we would less likely die. But I'm not really struggling with dying too much. I do die from time to time. So, and that this would cut down on that. But this also means that next level I would go toughness, then toughness again. We have multiple ways to play this. I definitely don't want to prioritize hacking. I think not dying would be pretty sweet. I want to put points into explosives, but I don't know. Not dying sounds pretty good. Let's start putting points into not dying. And the last level actually is going to give me health regen. We definitely want to have toughness 5 here. Survival is pretty important. Science is, you know, we want to get some crafting later, but it's not mandatory here and not the most important. So most likely it's gonna be 18 toughness, 19 toughness, 20 weapons, 21, 22 explosives, and I don't know, maybe some crafting. That would be nice. Of course, 24, which is gonna be pretty much obvious. Actually, toughness 24 is better than the weapons 24, maybe. Crit damage doubled. Actually, this is the headshot damage. So any kind of, that's gonna be ridiculous. Whatever, we're just gonna see. Maybe I'm just gonna find some skill books too.
Sergeant!
At ease.
Oh, wow, hey there. Look at you, Sergeant. When you helped us in Pasadena the other day, I was trying really hard not to panic because you were only a private. Sorry for underestimating you. I guess I should salute or something?
Come on, stop with the stairs. Anyway, what's going on between us? You kind of act like my wife, but, you know, we also... But I don't have any lines. Get ready for another scavenging run. Oh my god, is that a code for something? Getting ready for another scavenging run? Okay, how's Patrick?
How's Patrick?
Every day a little better. Aaron says he'll be back on his feet in no time. She's done a great job with him. I wish I could repay her somehow. It just doesn't seem that she needs anything.
Okay. So are you getting ready for another scavenging run?
Getting ready for another scavenging run?
No, I just came out here to catch my breath. Baron is giving us the entire evening off, believe it or not.
Doesn't sound like her. I need to report to Baron.
Wow. Okay, then. It is possible that, you know, she wanted something to happen, but I'm just way too clueless. Oh, knock. Hey, I'm here.
Rivers, DN 46890.
It does seem like this door just sucks.
The commander is expecting you in the control room, Sergeant.
I mean, the door looks okay, but... You know, I'm pretty sure that this, this doorway can be busted open pretty easily. with one explosive.
Maraschino cherries again. Where do they keep finding this shit?
I don't get it. How did they bring that?
Okay, what we got here? Map. Whoa.
A buggy down here.
Nice. Quest.
I'm going out soon. I haven't made my daily quota yet. I still have 3 more rats to catch. If you see one, let me know, okay?
Okay.
Hey, I'm just catching up with Mark. I'll get back to work in a couple of minutes. You won't tell, right? but no, seriously, you won't tell, right?
It's fine. Oh, we can go to the quartermaster. Also meet up with Brian.
Hey, Ryan, how's everything?
Exactly as you would imagine. Baron's keeping me busy. They weren't kidding when they said she's a hard ass.
About that camp, really? I bring it up now?
What happened after you started your camp?
Honestly, not that much. At least not in the beginning. When we gave up on the idea of getting in touch with anyone, we just tried to adapt. The temperatures fell, we had to scavenge for food. All of a sudden, that became our life.
Didn't you try to reach home?
Didn't you try to reach home?
Some people did. Most of us were scared of what we'd find if we did get home, so we conveniently said, we're stranded here anyways, and stayed. Well, I know how stupid it sounds, but we managed to have fun in our little commune. I still had my guitar with me. We talked a lot about how we're gonna be famous, because we're the only living band in the world.
You played in a band? What's the band name?
What was your band's name?
Well, we were thinking about changing it to Survivors, but something similar was already taken. We were just stupid kids, not realizing what was going on. We paid the price for it the first time we saw a tin can. I was tuning my guitar when I heard a strange noise. I found out later that it was a T-400. Must have heard me play. It didn't even have the decency to look scary. Maybe if it did, we wouldn't have just stood there when it started firing.
What did you do?
What did you do?
I froze. I didn't run to help. I didn't scream. I didn't even move. I just stood there, like a coward. A tin can got Tucker with a single bullet. Bam, just like that. 7 other people died before we finally destroyed that thing. Ironically enough, I was the one who delivered the final blow.
But
safe
how?
To say, it was the beginning of a new era.
And what did you hear?
What did you hear?
A lot of rumors going around of how she's sending insubordinate workers to the front line. And by insubordinate, I mean people who ain't willing to work 18 hours a day. Every day.
Well, sounds great. Oh, Quartermaster! Got some good stuff?
Do you need anything?
I don't know.
Can I see your hardware?
I guess that's a... Oh, this has a lot of upgrades on it? Oh, Rail Plasma RG01. It costs 4,000, but I already got one. Well, I'm not sure what should I buy here. At this point, I don't need those bullets. Because I found this weapon, I'm a little conflicted what we need. I think pipe grenade is a good choice. Still like these things. The can grenade seems like a good choice too. Large blast radius. Of course it would be better if I actually put points into it. Let's just buy these two. And that should be good enough for now. Yeah. That's fine. I don't need any more. Oh yeah, I can sell these. I'm never gonna use whites. I'm never gonna use anything with stability. It's too weak. I don't care about clip. I might care about fire rate. Damage. More damage. I don't care about clip at all. Or stability. Clip is trash. Fire rate and damage, maybe. Fire rate can be justified in very niche scenarios. So fire rate and damage, everything else, just sell that crap. But it's also not, I don't know. Yeah, well, that seems fine. We just sold some crap. Whatever. Yeah, we accept the transaction. And we still have to talk to the Baron. Seems like I may have a chat with people. This way? Oh.
Are you alright?
Me? Honey, I'm about the most well-adjusted person in this goddamn place. It's the others you should be concerned about.
You're Ryan?
You mean Ryan.
Ryan ain't so hot either, but that's another story.
Jennifer?
Jennifer?
I'm worried about her. I'm the one that asked Baron to give her team a little break. Jennifer's been busy scavenging supplies for the soldiers, and she hardly had time to see Patrick. And now she's finally got a day off. She's avoiding him like the plague.
Ooh. Patrick?
How's Patrick doing?
He's fine, but it wouldn't kill you if you checked on him yourself.
Do you need anything?
Is there anything you need?
No. I have to say, the Resistance is pretty well supplied. Don't tell me you miss running errands for me. I don't believe that for a second.
And what about something other than medicine?
Honey, I'm not shy. I'll let you know if I need anything, okay? But thank you for asking.
Take care.
Cool. What else we got? Come on. Oh, Patrick! I heard you are having a bad time here. You're not the only one. You're using the crayons that I brought you.
How are you doing?
Good. Aaron's going to let me leave in a couple of days. Thanks for bringing that chalk. I've been drawing a lot. I'd be so bored without it.
How do you like the shelter?
How do you like living in the shelter?
There's a lot of people here. I like that. I heard a funny joke yesterday. You want to hear it?
Sure.
Yeah, tell me.
What's brown and sticky? A stick.
I don't know. Do I want to encourage him with this crap? No! That wasn't funny. I don't get it.
I don't get it.
Yeah, me neither.
How's Jennifer?
How's Jennifer?
She's out a lot, but I understand. She's a scavenger.
I have to go.
Oh shit! Fucking hell! Oh my god! Oh! You could have timed that I have to go, like, 2 seconds later.
Alvin lost his spider scout again.
Man, I saw it crawling through the shelter earlier. Almost gave me a heart attack.
Oh, memorandum, John Connor. Oh my god. Commander Baron, I was very pleased to read the mission report from Pasadena. You are probably aware of this, but it is essential that we mobilize all troops in your area and abandon all level 3 outposts. I understand the consequences, and will take full responsibility for this. As for Private Rivers, I believe he deserves recognition for his actions. Perhaps a promotion is in order. I will leave that decision to you. I want you to keep him close. John Connor. That's what I suspect my real mission is, to kill John Connor. I'm an infiltration, a Terminator. with the job of killing John Connor.
You wanted to see me.
You're finally here. Good. I have a special task for you. I want you to head downtown to check on the doctor.
Doctor?
Alvin. He's out there making sure that our defense systems are working properly. Ever since we went radio silent, I had a small team of trustworthy messengers maintaining communication between our outposts. They haven't returned, so I want you to go downtown and see why that happened. Could be nothing, but Connor doesn't want any hiccups while he's up there in North Division preparing the attack on Skynet's central core.
Oh, I can ask about her story. Ooh. Okay. How did you end up here?
If you don't mind me asking, how did you end up here?
Excuse me if I act a little surprised, Sergeant. But no one in here thinks it's wise to ask their superior personal questions. But since you did, I'll humor you. So, how did I get here? The same way you did. I was born, raised, then given a gun. We don't really have a say in what we do, do we? Or do I assume too much? Was it any different for you? Why do you fight, Sergeant?
Because we don't have a choice. Because it's the right thing to do. Because we don't have a choice but to fight.
We don't have a choice.
Exactly. We're just going through the motions. Humans were fighting humans since the beginning of time. It just so happens that right now we have a common enemy. If it wasn't for the machines, we'd probably be fighting each other.
Yeah. So I guess we should thank the machines for teaching us compassion? No. I don't know if she's gonna appreciate that. Oh, come on, don't be so naive. So I guess we should thank the machines for teaching us compassion.
So, I guess we should thank the machines for teaching us compassion.
I guess we should. I have my special way of thanking them. A shot to the skull from a plasma rifle. Besides, I'm not a fighter. When I go out there in the middle of the night with my Westinghouse, I'm not looking for a fight. I look to seek and conquer. I'm not a fighter. I'm a bully.
I see. Who wants to be a bully?
Who wants to be a bully?
Believe me, there will come a time when you'll become whatever you need to be to survive. No one ever stands up to bullies. But I have to admit, it has its downsides. One of them being that no one ever asks me a personal question. At least not since Perry died. So congratulations, Rivers. Takes guts to stand up to a bully. I guess since your promotion, you got a little more cocky. Good for you.
Is there a problem with the radio?
Is there a problem with the radio?
The Annihilation Line is within spitting distance of downtown. We suspect that Skynet will be intercepting all transmissions from that location. So for now, we're going radio silent. That's why I need you to go there personally.
Central Core? I wouldn't mind if these questions a little bit elaborated on what I'm asking here. Like, what kind of like that's the question is. That is the question. Wow, this is just like, you know, Sergeant Rivers, you just go. You just do everything. That's fine.
Central Core?
Skynet's main reactor. The source of all their power. We shut down the Central Core, we shut down Skynet. Connor's preparing the attack as we speak. So you understand we can't have any critical complications at this stage.
It seems highly unlikely that this would be true. You know? If I was Skynet, you know, machines don't really like, you know, put all your eggs in one basket. That's just, no. No. That's not realistic. Okay, lads, I'm leaving. You guys cool with that? Yes. I mean, I'm asked about it, but I don't have anywhere else to go. I guess I can go back and trade, but that's it. That's all I can do. There's nothing else to do.
What? More wounded!
We need a medic over here!
I'm telling you, I saw something.
Kind of sounds like a ghoul. I'm here, guys. What's going on?
What's happening, Private?
A couple of aerials flew in and dropped containers full of metals. They started shooting while our defense systems did nothing.
What about the doctor? Where's Alvin?
He's still out there.
All right.
There's one more thing. Before I got hit and dragged here, I saw something. I'm not sure, but I think it was one of our own soldiers that led Skynet's attack.
Like this. Ooh. Soon they will be like, ooh, you can't trust the resistance. Oh, yeah. On behalf of Skynet, it seems like such a dumb move that you have all these human-like Terminators that are just like nothing like humans. But what if that's just the distraction? What if you have all these special Terminators that are exactly like humans, yet, you know, there's just nothing in between, so people think like, oh, that's not really possible. If there were like a bunch of Terminators in between, then, you know, believing that wouldn't be too unrealistic. Are you gonna just let me through?
Sergeant, we're outnumbered, and they keep bringing more wounded. We don't stand a chance. We have to evacuate.
Is Alvin still there?
He is, sir.
Then we're not leaving. We have to bring him back and see what the hell is going on with those defenses, and brief Commander Baron on what's happening here. I'm moving out. You stay here with the wounded.
You want me to break the radio silence?
At this point, it doesn't matter, does it?
Understood. Go ahead, sir.
I'll do that. Ooh, I like this. Okay, time for me to kill everybody. Oh my god. Maybe be a little careful.
You two follow me. We have to reach those defense systems.
No. You
yes,
guys,
sir.
You guys don't follow me. You're gonna get killed. He's gonna force me to go faster.
Spiders up ahead! Got it!
Lead the way!
Wait, what? You got him? Fucking bullshit. What are you using? I shot him with the biggest gun. There he is. At least I found so far. Okay.
This way!
Good to see you, Sergeant!
What's the status?
We've got a defensive perimeter set up just down the road.
Doesn't seem to be working.
Skynet dropped reinforcements behind their backs. Now they're between a rock and a hard place.
All right, we need to reach our guys. Let's clear the way.
Oh my god, what?
Keep moving!
Here they come!
They are? Then don't rush! Jesus Christ, people. Look at all the crazy rushing. Okay, let's loot these robots. Terminators. Let's take their stuff too. I think I found a new legendary stability. Come on, let's get up.
T-47, watch out!
Flank it!
Take out those smaller units!
No! Whoa! No! Oh, what the fuck is this? Slow mo? That's not what I want. I want heals. Oh shit. Shoot that down, boys. Oh my god, slow-mo
Ariel,
healing.
Take cover!
Oh my god, slow-mo reloading. God damn it. I feel like I need to go back. Wait, what? Okay, that's too weak. All we need is the big one.
Now! Shoot before it reboots!
Okay, this is not super useful for such engagement.
Finally!
This way! It's just beyond that overpass!
Rest in peace, robot. Okay, damage. I like that. 20% damage. That's pretty good. What I'm hoping to do is just build another damage build for my other item. I just want damage. Damage with damage and a little bit more damage. So, pre-damage if possible.
Flamethrowers!
Shoot the tank! Cover!
Oh no, lots of bullets. Shit. Alright, healing pack. Let's do another one. Kind of struggling with the sniper. The DPS is pretty low. So far the resistance plasma rifle is the highest DPS one. Loot a little bit here. What am I shooting at? Yeah, I see. Please, why are you blocking me? Go away. Are we actually dealing damage to it? They're dealing a little bit of damage. Oh my god.
We're through!
Explode!
Sergeant, take two of my men and proceed up that hill! We'll stay
Wait, what?
Here to keep
How do I have so many guys now? Wait up, guys. We need to do some looting. You rookies. That's not how you do it. You don't just rush ahead. God damn it. Fucking amateurs. This seems pretty linear. What's over here? This is where I'm supposed to camp. Can I build so 65 fire rate of whatever? I think this has the best DPS because, well, it also needs to reload though. So it, after 15 shots it overheats, and this is after 24 shots. You need to reload. What if I tried to upgrade it? So I have one damage. I have two damage, but that doesn't fit with it. We can combine that damage, but that would require a very specific one. That actually fire rate. So we can do something like that. That kind of works. Going for more damage is maybe possible. if he went with this in the first slot, but that doesn't really work because I don't have anything to combo it with. We can go for a little bit more fire rate. No, that doesn't work. Yeah, we can go for a little bit more damage. We can go 29 damage instead of 23 damage and a little bit of fire rate. So we can go something like this. Oh, yeah, that works. So that works. Kind of. This would be better. If we can connect this with a specific one, that would be really, really good. Oh, yeah, actually. Isn't that better? 23. No, this is technically better. God damn it. I can't put in any more damage. That doesn't work. So that's damage. But this would be block, and that's only fire rate. I think that's what we're gonna go with for now. You know, there's definitely room for improvement here. But I don't care about fire rate that much at all, especially with a weapon that overheats. So we're gonna put this at as the first item for now.
Follow me! We need to rescue the dock before those tanks reach us.
Jesus Christ! You guys are shouting quite a bit. Maybe I should. No. That's fine. He was just super loud.
Oh shit!
We're too late.
Why are you so loud? Oh man. Oh, is that a big ass robot in the distance? Seems that way. Oh man. I guess I'm just gonna help you guys out. Whatever you guys need it. Sniper.
This is it!
Take care of those drones!
I'll do that. Random drones.
Clear.
Wait here! I'll go get the doctor!
These guys are so loud. I don't know. I don't know what to do. Should I just cut it a little bit? No, but sometimes... No. I shouldn't do it, but these guys are super loud. If I change it now, then the speech volume of other characters is gonna be messed up. I guess they're shouting so loud because of the music we have.
Alvin! Oh my god, I'm actually glad to see you. What happened here? Why are the defense systems not working?
They are working, but their target filtering has been reset to non-hostile. One of Baron's messengers came with the order to temporarily change it, so I did.
Baron's messengers. We need to leave now.
Yes, let's do that. I'm all for that.
No! We were...
Are you alright? We need to move.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Escort secured.
Crap, I need to heal.
Ah!
Go!
I don't like this! I don't like any of this!
Spice. If I get health regen, then I don't have to worry about that anymore.
Ariel!
No! I love. What? What the fuck? What? How am I not losing Galvin there? I was healing to not die and sprinting after him. I wasn't really dicking around. ship.
Okay, go!
It's turning around! It's right behind us!
Don't look back!
Good idea!
What am I supposed to do here? Can I just... That's what I expected. Okay. I didn't lose you now. We're back at the resistance shelter. Would you look at that? That was easier than I thought. Why do you have to, like, destroy copters that are shooting at you? You can just outrun them.
You go talk to Commander Baron. I've had enough excitement for one day.
I'll do that.
Lay still.
Anything new I can do? Oh, yeah. A lot of...
Don't move.
Thanks for getting us out of there, Sergeant.
What's up?
I know you're busy, but I found something. Something I think you'll like. A tape from back in the day. I want to play it for you, but my boombox is busted. So if you're out there and find one that works, bring it to me, okay?
Can't you ask Jennifer or one of the other scavengers for help?
I already did, but they couldn't find anything. Just think about it, okay?
Okay, well, we're not touching that. Radio for Ryan. Can go this way.
Jacob.
Hey, what's on your mind?
What's on your mind?
Ever since you asked me about Peter, I can't stop thinking about him. Like a teenage girl. That's your fault, young man.
Is that so? Have you tried looking for him?
Have you tried looking for him?
I've looked for him for a while. I went to the place where we said we'd meet if we ever got separated. But he wasn't there. Maybe it's stupid. Maybe I should stop thinking about him. He's probably dead by now. God knows he can't take care of himself.
Do you want to find him?
Do you want to find him?
Sometimes I think I should drop everything and go. I would get an earful from Baron, but she's nothing I can't handle. Anyway, what I didn't tell you before is that during Judgment Day, I lost a child. Our child. I don't know if it would have happened anyway, but I like to blame the machines for that. I think that Peter felt with Taylor we were given a second chance. God. He's still out there waiting for me, isn't he? Probably sitting in his rocking chair back in our house in Hollywood Hills. Oh, where the hell are you, Peter?
Dad, how are the wounded doing?
How are the wounded doing?
The few that came back, they're doing fine. We patched them up, and at this point we're just sitting and waiting.
Sounds good. At least it wasn't a really awkward conversation. Oh, yeah. Laura and Mark.
Hey, are you all right? We just got the news about the attack. They're getting closer, aren't they?
Hey, glad to see you alive. Thanks for sticking your neck out for us. I wanted to tell you that, you know, just in case.
Thanks. I'm not really just approaching you guys just to, you know, get thanks all the time. Oh, Jennifer. Hey there.
Huh. Wasn't expecting to find you here. You always seem to be out these days.
Yeah, that's true. Lately, I've been making extra runs to stock up on resources. The truth is, I was even thinking about leaving. But right now, I'm just waiting for my team to head back to downtown to look for other survivors. Let's hope there still are some.
Is there something on your mind?
Is there something on your mind?
Actually, I have a secret to tell you. You have a fan. Patrick really looks up to you. It's good for him to have a role model. And I don't think he could have chosen better.
Oh my god. I don't think I'd make a good role model. Thank you. It means a lot. He's gonna like that.
Thank you. It means a lot.
Are you kidding? It's the least I can do for helping us all this time. If you hadn't found us back in Pasadena, I don't know what would have happened. Well, actually, I do. Exactly what the others said would happen. People were talking about the Annihilation Line months before it came. My father, of course, tried to turn it all into a joke.
Hey, that's my move. Knowing your father, it couldn't have been a good joke. But what did you think about it?
But what did you think about it?
I didn't know what to think. Travelers would bring all sorts of gossip with them. But this kept coming back. When Patrick asked me if I was scared, I lied and said that I wasn't. You could feel the mood change at the house. The community my father tried to build started falling apart. Fewer and fewer people were coming by. And if they did, they weren't always friendly. We started to notice things going missing. Little things at first. People got nervous. And with time, it even got to my father.
What do you mean? Did it ever get to you? Seems like we only get one choice here. Did it ever get to you?
Did it ever get to you?
Of course it did. For the first time in my life, there were only the three of us at the house. After a while, my father changed the sign from welcome to beware.
Ooh.
He put a lock on the door and started carrying a shotgun. I didn't even know he owned a gun. He always said he didn't believe in them. I wanted us to leave our house and run, but he didn't want to listen. Said it was the only place he could keep us safe. Thanks for letting me spill my guts like that.
I see Patrick's doing better.
I see that Patrick's doing better.
He is. He's a fighter. Certainly has more courage than I do.
So, why do you want to leave? Why did you want to leave? She currently wants to leave, no? You wanted to leave? Is that the case? Tell me.
Why did you want to leave?
In the face of what's going on now, it will sound stupid, but it just got to be a bit much, you know? With Patrick hurt, I started to wonder if I'm even doing him any good by sticking around. I've been trying to protect him all this time, but I couldn't. I've proven that much already. First in Pasadena, then at our hideout. I was thinking that maybe he'd be safer here at the shelter. But don't worry, I changed my mind since.
Fair enough. So, we have a chat with Alvin. After that, we just gotta go to the Baron. Oh. I totally underestimate the... I kinda overestimate the size of this place. Yeah, that's more correct. Alvin! Oh. From the back, you could've been a pirate, but...
Did you talk to her? Is she mad at me? If I follow her orders, then I'm a bad guy. If I don't follow her orders, then I'm a lousy, incompetent egghead without a spine. There's no winning with her.
That's it? Maybe we're gonna have new conversation options after we talk to her. Hey, Baron.
Rivers. You want to explain to me what the hell happened?
We lost downtown.
I know that much. But how's that possible? What happened to our defense systems?
Alvin says one of our soldiers came with an order directly from you to reset the target settings for non-lethals.
He said what? All right. This is what I want you to do. Find whoever is responsible for sending that order. All the messengers have GPS tracking, so we're keeping tabs on their location. Find them and bring them to me.
Understood.
And Rivers, despite what I might say about our resident egghead, I truly have a hard time believing that my men are incompetent. So expect the unexpected. And you know what I mean by that.
Do you think the infiltrator's back?
We won't be sure until you find those messengers and confirm my suspicion.
Now that you mention it...
What?
One of our soldiers said that it looked as if one of our guys led Skynet's attack.
That only supports my case. As soon as you know what's going on, radio me.
Who's Perry? Pretty random question. Who's Perry?
Who's Perry? You mentioned him before.
The best soldier I ever fought beside. He was the one who brought me into the Resistance. It's actually a funny story. Years ago, when I was just a kid, I saw a Skynet drone attacking some guy. Without thinking, I grabbed a rock and jumped on it. The guy was screaming the whole time while I beat the metal to the ground. Only when I was done did I realize he was trying to stop me.
You killed a drone with a rock?
You killed a drone with a rock?
I was young and stupid. Thank God the drone wasn't really armed, otherwise I wouldn't be here to tell you the story. He was a Resistance scientist, and that drone was one of his projects. So you can imagine he wasn't too happy when I smashed it to pieces. But he wasn't alone. There was this huge guy with a rifle on his shoulder, almost choking with laughter. It sure made his day.
That huge guy was Perry?
That huge guy? Was that Perry?
Yes, it was. Commander Perry was in charge of this division before me. That scientist later told me that was the first time he ever heard Perry laugh. Somehow, Perry and I connected. He taught me how to channel my anger and get it under control. He introduced me to Connor, and that's how I got to the 132nd.
So what happened to the scientist?
Whatever happened to the scientist?
He was always doing his experiments, trying to outsmart Skynet. One day he fucked up, and because of that he's no longer with us. I'd never thought I'd be reminiscing about the day I met them. This may come as a surprise to you, but it was the first metal I ever destroyed.
Sounds like you were late joining the Destroy Skynet campaign. Not surprised, you're just a kid. It's kind of funny.
I'm not surprised. You were still just a kid.
That doesn't mean I didn't have a kill count back then. It just consisted of people.
What?
But that's a different story.
That you're just gonna leave it like that? By the way, I'm a murderer. You want me to break this radio silence?
You want me to break radio silence?
They have a head start on us. At this point, we can't afford to lose any time.
Okay. I guess we're heading out. Alright, leveled up 2 times. Patrick wants to talk to me. I also have 2 skill points to distribute. And I'm at level 19. We can go with toughness. 4. And we can just... We'll go with weapons. 4. Explosive 2 and 3. So it's mostly about ordering it properly. I would like a toughness 5. I don't think this is a super long game. But fun. For sure. I'm actually going the wrong way. Which way I'm supposed to go? I don't know. Can I look at the map? Patrick is coming toward me. No, Patrick! It's not gonna happen! Oh shit. No. Actually... Let's talk, Patrick.
Patrick, you're up?
There are people who need help more than me. Anyway, I can't talk. I have to bring something important to Eren.
Just sitting right there. Okay, then. I guess he really doesn't like me. And Jennifer just lied to me. Hey, Douglas. It's like, oh, sorry, I can't make it. I have to talk to this very, very important person right next to me. I just have to give her something. That's it. But it's super important. I can't talk now. Talk in few weeks, okay? No big deal. Okay. Oh, actually, leave shelter. That's probably a bad idea right now. No, cancel. Boys, I don't want to go. So, this is where we're going to end it for now. Thanks for watching, guys, and I want to take the buggy. And see you next time.